I grew up in East Texas. I am one of 10 kids. I like to start with that because it's really out of the ordinary and it catches people off guard. I have an incredible mother and father. They raised us to always do music and ministry. So like music and ministry have gone hand in hand in my life since I was really young. In fact, when I was 5, we were missionaries in Romania, and part of the way that we raised support for that was literally to dress in the same outfit, which is really embarrassing, and travel around church to church and sing songs. I was just blessed with an incredible home life, incredible mom and dad. They've been married over 40 years, and from a really young age, they taught us the gospel, and they taught us that reaching people and sharing Jesus was the most important thing in this world. But from a very young age, I really struggled with my mental health. I actually wrote my first song at 9 years old because I was struggling with, my mom had just miscarried what would have been my little brother. And I remember it just really impacted my heart. And I literally went outside, sat on a tire swing, and wrote my little pink journal, the first song I would ever write. And it kind of started something for me. From then on, music and writing songs was like my therapy, because throughout my high school years and older, I struggled with panic attacks and I struggled with anxiety and depression. And I had people ask me before, you have such an incredible home life. Like, why do you have a reason to struggle with this? And it's just so funny because sometimes you feel guilty. I don't know what's wrong with me. But at the end of the day, I realized we live in a broken world, and a part of that brokenness is it can affect our minds, it can affect our health. And now I'm able to do music and write about these things that I'm so passionate about and to share that hope with others. I moved to Nashville about 7 years ago, and it's been a long journey, but it finally all led up to this. I released a song that had to do with mental health and with that struggle called I'll Be Okay. And I ended up signing my record deal 1 year ago, and now I'm finally able to share all these songs with the world. So I'm just so, so grateful. Every songwriter has a reason behind what they are creating. For me, it's just that whoever may hear it, whoever may be worshiping to it or singing it, would know that God wants them just as they are. They can come and be vulnerable and honest and authentic and not hide one thing. And he loves them and he cares about them and he is with them and he thinks they're special. And for me, that understanding of who Jesus is has changed my life forever. And I'm hoping my songs can set people free in the same way.